the spirit that opposes the Spirit of God. There's some things the Word of God says don't do.
Amen.
That means don't do it.
Amen. That's right.
There's some things the Spirit of God will touch your heart about and says you need to leave it alone.
Amen.
You need to leave it alone.
Amen.
Some things pretty cut and dry.
That's
right. I don't want you to get mad at me and throw a songbook tonight. I don't want you to throw your shoe at me tonight. I'm just going to preach holiness to it just a little while.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible tells us that we're to come out from among the world, the influence of the spirit of the world. That means don't look like it. That means don't act like it. Don't be partaker of it. But come out away from the persuasion of it. Come out from among the influence of it. Be separate. We call it sanctification.
Right. Thank you, Lord.
A second definite work of grace.
Right.
Being sanctified. Being consecrated to God.
Amen.
You got problems with the world, you can't be consecrated to God.
Right.
We got to get rid of affections and desires and passion for the world before we can be consecrated unto God.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
Now, come on, folks, jump on here with me. The Bible says, listen, for us to not let our adorning to be that of outward adorning.
Amen.
Wearing silver or gold. But rather let it be the hidden man of the heart. That's what the Bible says.
Amen.
That's what God says.
That's right. Amen.
That's very plain and simple to understand.
Amen.
Don't let your outward adorning be such.
That's right.
Don't do it.
Amen.
But we got a church world today that's trying to worship God, and they are doing it. And most of them know better to do it.
Amen.
It ain't right worship. It ain't real worship. And it ain't worship being received by God. I'm telling you, the only thing God receives is that has been sanctified, that has been consecrated. That's the only thing that God is receiving. Amen. That's what the Bible says.
Amen.
Leave it alone. Separate yourself from but preacher.
Yes, amen. Come on.
Who you gonna leave, man of God?
Right.
Tell you how that thing works, folks. There's some things that people can't do that are personal convictions. And God says, don't do it. Because when they were doing it in the world, they had deep roots in it. That thing had a hold of them. And God says, they may not be sin, but it had a hold to them. And God says, now just leave it alone, lest you be tempted. Personal convictions. This silver and gold that people flash around. Hey, this is what happens. They get it all over themselves. You can say what you want to say, but when somebody puts that stuff on, it does this to them.
That's right.
That's right.
It does. Blows them up.
Yes, it does.
A spirit of pride moves over them. And it's like, look at this here. He just lifts them up, amen. I'm telling you, God says, don't do it. Don't you do it. Don't you put it on, amen. Oh my God, if we want to be received by God, we got to leave it alone. We got to come out from among it. I'm telling you, you want to get worship back in the house of God? Line up with the Bible. Line up with the Word of God. Do it God's way. You'll find the power of God. One more time, coming down among the people of God.
Thank you,
Lord.
Yes.
Amen. My God, Israel was full of it. And Aaron said, break it off and give it to me, and I'll make you a God out of it.
Right.
And they had that goal to fashion a God out of it. And they bow down. And they worship it.
Amen.
God said, don't do it, folks.
Right.
He said, come out from among you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. You say, preacher, you're killing it, you're killing it, you're killing it. Hold on, no, I'm just preaching holiness.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Brother, we're living in a mixed up church age.
Amen.
Amen.
Confused.
Yes.
The people at McDonald's know more than some of the people in the church know.
That's right.
You know, preacher, next time you go to the bathroom, McDonald's, look in the bathroom door. Brother Logan, I got a sign on a man's bathroom, he got two legs. They got a sign on a woman's bathroom, she's got a skirt on. Amen. The world even knows, folks, what's wrong with God's people, amen. I'm telling you something's wrong. God said, leave it alone, my God, man. If you a man, look like a man. If you a woman, look like a woman. Leave it alone, amen.
Yes.
I'm telling you, folks, we're living in a warped society. We don't think nothing about a woman wearing breeches. But let me put a skirt on to come to revival tomorrow night. I know what you'd be ready to do. You'd be ready to turn around that door and go home, and I wouldn't blame you. Amen. Because something would register inside of you to say, hey, something's wrong with this. This ain't right. Well, I'm telling you, God said it ain't right. Woman, come out of him, amen. Leave him alone. God didn't make you like a man. He made you a woman, amen. He didn't make you to show your shape and your figure, amen. He made you to dress modestly and dress like a woman, amen. Worship God right, we gotta live right. Amen. If we're gonna have God's power and God's glory coming down among us one more time, we got to worship Him in truth.
Yes.
We gotta worship God right.
That's right, brother.
Now, somebody that don't know no better, keep coming to the house of God. If better God's preaching you enough, you'll learn better.
That's right.
If you listen to the Spirit of God, He'll teach you better. Well, we got to get back to it.
Yes, amen.
We got to get back to the landmark.
Yes, amen.
Worshiping God.
Amen.
Lord, help us. When we come to the day and time where people's got that.
Amen.
Pantomime teams come into the house of amen. God and leotards performing.
Right.
They call it worship.
That's right.
It ain't nothing but secular world entertainment.
Amen.
That's all it is.
Amen.
It appeals to the flesh. That's all it does, amen. Amen. People want to feel something. Amen. God still got a feeling. We got to live right to feel it, though. We got to come by God's word. We got to hear the word of God. And God had come down one more time among His people.
Amen. Praise God.
We got to worship God tonight in spirit. We got to worship God in truth.
We
got to get back to the Bible. The word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Why is it important tonight, preacher? Why should we worship God? Why should we worship God? Well, number one, tonight we should worship God because He's worthy of our worship. He's worthy. In fact, David said, I will call upon the Lord, for He is worthy to be praised. We've got to worship God tonight because He's worthy for praise. Second reason tonight we ought to worship God is because He created us to worship Him.
Right.
We've been created and formed and fashioned in the image of God to worship God.
Amen.
We were made for God.
Praise God.
We were made for the service of the Lord.
Amen.
Now I know everybody don't live for God tonight, but we were made to serve the Lord for His purpose. And Paul said the word of God, for by Him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in the earth. He said both visible and invisible.
Amen.
Whether thrones, dominion, principalities, or powers, He said all things were created by Him, for Him.
Amen.
We were created for the purpose of God.
Amen.
That we might worship Him.
Amen.
And give Him glory.
Thank you, Lord.
The third thing tonight, the reason why we ought to worship God, is, folks, because it brings us into the presence
Amen.
Of God.
Yeah.
Worship and praise escorts us into the presence
Amen.
Of God.
Yes.
Should understand something tonight. What the church does, we don't do just out of a realistic or ritualistic fashions, amen. There's a reason why we do what we do. There's a reason why we have the order we have in the holy churches. We come in this place here, first of all, we should come in here with our minds on God. Hey, David said, I will into His gates with thanksgiving, into His courts with praise. When mine and your hand grabs a hold of that door and swing it open, there ought to be a praise resonate from our heart. If it ain't coming from from our lips. It ought to be resonating from our heart. I've come to the house of God to meet God. I've come here to worship Him. I've come here to praise Him. I've come here to magnify God. He come to catch up on the latest gossip, but I come to get in contact. I've come to see God. I've come to get in the presence of God. We ought to come with a mind of worship God.
Amen.
Didn't we enter into this worship service and somebody says, get a red back hymnal, turn the page such and such. Folks, we don't just pick that book up and go to mocking words, mouthing words. What we do is we get in that song book and we apply every word that we sing to our hearts and our lives. Amen. We're into that worship service. We're singing unto the Lord, amen, as though He was here sitting on the front row, and He is here in spirit, amen. And we're worshiping Him in song. We're making melody unto God by the song of God.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. And I believe we ought to put all we got in the songs. It is the song service that sets the tone.
Thank you, Lord.
The worship service.
Thank you, Jesus.
That song service brings us in the presence of God. Man, I believe we play that piano. We need to play it like we played it for Jesus. We beat drums. We ought to beat them like we beat them for God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. I know whenever you was out there, you're just like anybody else. Whatever you enjoy doing, you enjoy doing, and you put your all into it. You put everything into it. That's how God wants us to worship Him, folks. He wants to put us to put everything in the worship service. God, preacher, I'm tired of my body. I know y'all are. Tired of my body. But if we can bring ourselves to lay that thought aside, just get our mind fixed on God and get our hands up. Worship God. Preacher, I'm afraid I'm going to be in the flesh. Honey, don't worry. You're already in the flesh.
That's right.
People scared to death they're going to get in the flesh to worship God. You're already in the flesh.
Yes, amen.
We start in the flesh. We live in this flesh. We start worshiping God in the flesh. Think about it is, the more we worship God,
amen,
the more the antennas goes up. The clearer the reception begins. And after a while, the antennas go up long enough. The praise rolls off the lips long enough. After a while, you'll feel an arc. You'll feel a connection there. After a while, you just change gears. Move out the flesh and into the Spirit of God. Worship God. Let God have His way. God wants us to worship Him.
Amen.
Somebody said, preacher, I'll move when God moves. God moved 6,000 years ago. He's already moved. And He's awaiting on us, amen. And day, night, long, listen to me. All the kind hearts you can. If you don't need your help, hold them down. And really know, amen. They'll be fine, not where they're at, amen. All you got to do is pay Him no mind. Get up and worship God. Praise God. Magnify God for what He's done, amen. God in heaven, I don't think we ought to magnify God only for what He has done. I think we ought to look for tomorrow and praise Him for what He's going to do. Amen.
Yeah.
Praise God.